Shanti Stupa, a journey to 74th World Peace Pagoda. The Peace Pagoda is a Buddhist stupa which is symbol of peace and unity amongst people from all walks of life, irrespective of race, creed and caste. In early 20th century, when mass destruction was taking a toll, peace pagodas were built under guidance of Buddhist monk Nichidatsu Fuji to spread peace. There are 7 peace pagodas in India and one of them is World Peace Pagoda in Delhi. History. The World Peace Pagoda or Vishwa Sanchi Stupa in Delhi was inaugurated on 20th November 2008 by monks and nuns of Nichiren Buddhist Order or Nipponzan Myohoji, the Dalai Lama and the then Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, Mr. Nazib Jung. The Peace Pagoda project in Delhi was envisaged by Buddhist monk Nichidatsu Fuji in 1978 when he was recognized with the Jawaharlal Nehru Award for International Understanding by the Government of India. Architecture. The Peace Pagoda has a mound-like structure which inhabits a relic which was brought to India by the Dalai Lama. As written by Giuseppe Tucci in his comprehensive work on stupas, the shape of pagoda represents the Buddha crowned and sitting in meditation on a lion throne. His crown is top of the spire, his head is the square at the spire's base, his body is the vase shape, his legs are 4 steps of lower terrace and the base is his home. There are 4 deities of Buddha around the dome, which are revered during the traditional prayer service by visitors. Main attraction. Adding to the beauty of the pagoda, the park around is built in a traditional Japanese manner, which is also a joint venture of the Fuji Guruji Vishwa Shanti Stupa Committee and the Delhi Development Authority. One can also view the Humayun's tomb from the fringes around the stupa. Also, the World Peace Pagoda in Delhi is 74th in row of pagodas around the globe. Tourism. The serene and divine World Peace Pagoda has lately attracted travelers and tourists. Located in the heart of Indraprastha Park, it not only adds to the beauty but also acts a symbol of peace. People come and offer prayers, chanting the lines that are written underneath the deity of Lord Buddha. Those who maintain the park add that the park is visited mainly by school children during the weekdays. On holidays and weekends, the park is thronged by tourists and locals alike. If you enjoyed watching our video, do like and share it and subscribe to our YouTube channel now.